At a riverside bar just outside Bangkok, a delicious revolution is underway. Every Saturday, Chit Beer Microbrewery opens for beer lovers and those who want to learn the craft of craft beer. It's getting very, very popular now because when people know more about the concept, that yeah, we can make beer ourselves at home, they're excited, said Wicket Cyclow, better known as Chit. But these weekly classes are an act of rebellion. Home brewing is illegal in Thailand. To get a beer making license, Thais must be able to produce 100,000 liters a year and have $400,000 in the bank, which effectively shuts out small players. The 1950 Liquors Act also protects the two giant conglomerates that dominate the cheap lager market, ThaiBev with its Chang, and the infamous Chugova, and Boonrod Brewery's Saikhart and Leo Beer. Thai craft brewers are forced to take their recipes to breweries overseas and then import their bottles back into Thailand, paying hefty tax. Most brew in Asia, but not all. Phuket's Full Moon Breweries makes its fruity Kalua Pale Ale in New South Wales and the logo for its Chitra IPA is a Muay Thai fighter with a koala head. Melbourne's Red Dot Brewery produces oddball flavours from the Lamzig Brewery, including Sticky Mango, Pale Ale, If You Like Piacolata, Saison, Morning in Monsoon, Stout. But the imported Thai beer is sold at premium prices. So for the maverick of Thailand's rebel brew scene, defying the law is not just about tasty beverages, but freedom and self-sufficiency. When people feel they are empowered to do something, to rely on oneself, then I think many, many good things will come after we can make beer ourselves at home, Chit said. That's my vision. Chit's vision started with two flops. Thailand's evangelist of ales first tasted craft beer while studying in the United States. He put the idea in the back of his mind, thinking it would be a good hobby later in life. I am afraid I am going to feel lonely, so if I can brew beer then friends are going to come over, he laughed. If they are having a party they remember that they have to invite Chit, because Chit makes beer. But 5 years ago, he decided retirement was too long to wait, and ordered a do-it-yourself kit on the internet. His first two batches failed because he threw out the yeast, thinking the small packet was a deodorizer. But the third batch was a success and sparked a passion that has proved contagious. By mid-afternoon, the bar is packed. While most punters sample the small batch offerings on tap and watch the river pass from the sunny deck, a small group huddles around Chit taking notes, measuring out grain and asking questions. I didn't realize how many types of ingredients there are to make beer, said Dominic, a Bangkok resident from the United Kingdom. I have just tasted the first batch and it tastes amazing. Chit Beer is located on the island of Koh Kret, about 20 kilometers north of Bangkok. The classes are kept low-key, but Chit has had his run-ins with the law, after undercover officers carried out a particularly thorough investigation. They drank a lot of my beer and played around in my brewery but I didn't know who they are, he recalled.